living. Very funny, and he was always full of pranks, and he was always being silly. But on the other end of the spectrum, when it had to do with the security of Israel and all that stuff, he was so serious. But that's Mike. That was, you know, it was the wool hat and the baseball and the hockey. Shalom uvracha. But Israel was always there.
I've really just never seen somebody just thrive and just love Israel like he did. He had such a passion for it, and no matter what was going on here, he had nothing bad to say about Israel, which was just amazing, because it's very hard to be a new immigrant here by yourself and to deal with Israeli bureaucracy, and everyone complains, and there's nothing, what are you going to do? That's how it is. But Mikey, no matter what, he had that characteristic smile on his face, and he'd say, well, you know, this and this happened, but I'm loving it here.
Well, I met Mike Levin, it was about 6 or 7 months before he went to the army. He called to me sometime in Yom Shishi, and I said, hello, I'm Mike Levin, and people say that if I want to go to the army, you are the man. Listen, Mike, I don't know you. To put your name, I have to meet you. I spoke with all the young kids in the Ulpan who came to learn Hebrew, and I met a young fellow, very small one, with a kippah on his head, and all the time he's smiling and smiling and smiling. Mike, what do you smile all the time? I don't know, but put me in a parachute unit. I'm smile, but I'm strong. Don't worry. Mike, go to eat some chicken, some cheese, bread, be fed a little bit. It's okay, I'm strong, I will prove it to you.
מבחינתי הר הרצל, מקום הקבורה של מייקל, זיכרונו לברכה. מקום של גיבורים, מקום שבו נחים את מנוחתם כל האנשים שעשו והקריבו למען המדינה, ראשי ממשלות, מפקדים גדולים, ומייקל לוין.
מי ינחנו דרך